We're going to talk about naming chemical compounds or nomenclature today. The first thing that we're going to look at is naming ionic compounds. We're going to look at naming it as well as putting it together. When I'm presented with the formula, such as Ba3N2, that formula or formula unit represents the chemical compound that is named barium nitride. That is the name of this compound, barium nitride. So we're going to talk about all the aspects of it, why it's called that, how I put it together, all of those sorts of things. The first thing that we're going to look at specifically is we're going to look at ionic compounds. Ionic compounds are made up of ions. You may recall that ions are either cations or anions. Cations are positively charged, anions are negatively charged. In an ionic compound, the cation is almost always a metal, and the anion is almost always a non-metal. We're not going to talk about any of the exceptions today. So the cations is the metal. For example, the barium would be the cation here, and the non-metal, nitrogen, would be the anion here, the negatively charged species, the negatively charged ion. All right. Cations and anions, again, they're split up by metals and nonmetals, so it's useful to remember the dividing line on the periodic table that divides the metals from the nonmetals. The metals are to the left, the nonmetals are to the right. The exception, of course, is hydrogen. Hydrogen's the exception to almost everything we do. Hydrogen is a nonmetal, so even though he's listed over here on the left-hand side of the periodic table, he belongs over here with these guys. All right, the cation, the metal, has a charge. It has a positive charge. These are charges that simply must be memorized. Here's how they work. Anybody in group 1A, Roman numeral 1A, has a plus 1 charge. Anybody in group 2A, Roman numeral 2A, has a plus 2 charge, or a 2 plus charge. You see it written both ways. Aluminum, who is in group 3A, has a plus 3 charge as a metal ion, as a metal cation. Anybody in group 1A has a plus 1. Anybody in group 2A has a plus 2. Aluminum has a plus 3. All right. The rest of the metals consist of all of the transition elements, those in the B groups, and all of the metals below aluminum, below that stair step line, have variable charges. Their charges can vary, their plus charges. They may have ions that have plus ones, they may have ions that have plus twos, and so on. For example, Fe, I might find Fe with a plus one, and iron with a plus one charge. I might find iron with a plus two charge. I might find iron with a plus three. It's variable. To name the cations, it's very simple as you name the metal. For example, if I'm looking at lithium with his plus one charge because he's in group 1A, the name of him is the lithium ion. If I'm looking at aluminum with his plus three charge, because aluminum's always plus three, I call him the aluminum ion. Aluminum ion. If I'm looking at iron, since iron's charge is variable, I have to specify. If I'm looking at the iron with a plus 2, I can't just call him an iron ion because I don't know if I'm talking about plus 1, plus 2, or plus 3, so I put a Roman numeral. The Roman numeral matches the charge. So this is the iron plus 2 ion, the iron Roman numeral 2 ion. The Roman iron plus 3 ion would be named iron Roman numeral 3 ion. So that's how I name those positively charged ions. Let's get some space and work on the nonmetals. Let's work on the negatively charged ions. Let's work on the anions. All right. The nonmetals are anions. The nonmetals are negatively charged. And when I name them, I change the name a little bit. You may have noticed that up here, this is called barium nitride. Even though it's consistent of the nitrogen, I don't call it barium nitrogen, I call it barium nitride. I have a way to change the ending of these names. So nitrogen as an ion is called the nitride ion. Oxygen as an ion is called the oxide ion. Fluorine is called the fluoride ion, and so forth. Now let's talk about their charges. Again, there's a pattern to the charges, and the first thing that we'll notice is that we won't be considering these in group 8A. The elements in group 8A don't tend to form ionic compounds, and so we're ignoring them. Starting with the group 7A elements, I notice that all of these will have a negative 1 charge in an ionic compound. The group 6A elements have a negative 2 charge in ionic compounds. The 5A elements have a negative 3. Carbon in an ionic compound would be a -4, and if boron ever showed up in an ionic compound, it'd be a -5, but it doesn't really tend to show up in ionic compounds. So for example, nitrogen with his -3 charge is called the nitride ion. Again, he has a -3. I simply must memorize that based on his position in the periodic table. But I also must memorize that I don't call him the nitrogen ion, I call him the nitride ion. That's just the way we name them. Oxygen would have a -2, and this would be called the oxide ion. Oxygen becomes the oxide ion. Fluorine would have a -1, and it would be the fluoride ion. This is one of the most misspelled elements on the periodic table, so watch yourself. This is the fluoride ion. Fluorine becomes the fluoride ion. So that's the notation that I use. I have to memorize the charges based on the periodic table, and I have to memorize how they're named, again, based on the rules that we use. Now when I come to put them together, if I look back over here at the first example that we talked about, this barium nitride. All right, let's look at this guy. He's made up of the barium ion. Barium is not on this periodic table. I've cut it off too soon, but if you look at your periodic table, you'll notice he's in group 2A, which means he's +2. And the nitride ion, which based on his position in the periodic table, is a -3. So I have a Ba with a +2, an N with a -3, and in order to put them together to form a compound, I need to put them together such that their charges balance. Essentially, the ionic charges have to match. Well, +2 and -3 don't match. So I have to think of how many of each do I need to make them match. For example, I need, in this example, if I have 3 bariums, I have a total of a +6 charge. And 2 nitrogens would give me a total of a -6 charge. Now their charges balance. In order to write this formula in its simplest form, I'll use subscripts. And the subscripts will be that there are 3 bariums, 1, 2, 3, and 2 nitrogens, 1, 2, to represent the number of ions of each of those there are. And so I'm looking at 3 barium ions. Let me make that a little better. And 2 nitrogen ions to balance the charges. And this is why the formula is Ba3N2. The name barium nitride is because I'm simply naming the metal ion and the non-metal ion.